one. What a way to spend your Sunday afternoon in Omaha, Nebraska. A top 25 matchup as two teams battle not only for Big East position, but NCAA tournament seeding. A lot on the line here. Butler won the first meeting, 71-57. That was in early January at Hinkle Fieldhouse. Here's Bella. Off a screen, rolls around for a three, and a real good sign for Creighton early because he struggled to play.
Yeah, he's been getting defended at a really high looks. But when you're a shooter like that, you can get anything to go down.
Here's Christian Bishop driving to the rim for a two-hand stop. 5-0 start for the Blue Jays. Effective doing that at Hinkle, weren't they?
Absolutely.
Entry pass into the post taken away by Christian Bishop. Long and athletic sophomore got his hands on that one.
Urgency for Butler to get back, transition, find the shooters. Crucial.
Legorowski, he's one of those shooters, and he gets the home run roll.
You got two mid-range guys in the big team. You got an advantage with Enzi down there.
Butler's out rebounded 19 of their 27 opponents this year, but only once in the last four games. Ballock with 10 on the shot clock. Attacking from the outside, the lob. What a play from Ballock.
Understand he's going to get run off the line. And I confuse him with the, you know, the Bad Boys Pistons or anything like that, but this team's played with the collective toughness and fight on the defensive end of the floor that has been increased from years past.
With their offense, you don't need a ton of defense. Roll into the rim. It's Calvin Jones on the run.
And that empty side pick is 11 times this year. He's averaging 9 points per game.
Long and strong, but an errant pass and a turnover to Zegarowski. Zegarowski running against Badley. The kick into the corner to Alexander. Thought about it. Zegarowski will fire. And that
we're out there in Alexander's first to knock down some shots for Butler.
Only one game in double figures this year. That was against Marquette on January 24th. He walked off with that three. Rebound by Calvin Jones. Second chance for Creighton. Zagorowski's three.
Calvin Jones with an outstanding offensive rebound, kick out, extra pass. Marcus Zegarowski buries it.
Best he's had here.
Creighton's just the hottest team in the Big East right now. Playing with confidence, playing with a free mind.
Christian Bishop, nowhere to go. Kicks it out to Mahoney.
Who hits the three? Mahoney.
Largest lead for the Blue Jays at 8. Mahoney. Range from the 3 of 8 as a team. Great 5 of 11 to start from beyond the arc. Zegarowski has just hit his third. He's got 8 points. And the Creighton
Baldwin, when Kamar Baldwin goes out there like to play through Enzi, and he's not on the floor right now.
Big offensive rebound for Calvin Jones. Caleb Battle on the floor. The 6'5 freshman taking over for Kamar Baldwin. In the corner, Ballock's three is good. Yes. 10-point advantage for the Blue Jays. Mitch Ballock. As the threes have started to fall for the Let It Fly Jays, they're up by 10. Back out to Zegarowski. He's got 10 on the shot clock. Jones with a screen. Opens up the three. That one goes down and in. 4-4. Zegarowski for three. They only had 7 in the first meeting against Butler for the entire game. Zegarowski, a little floater in the paint. Not going to go. But Christian Bishop there to clean it up. Boy. Baldwin limping at the end of the play for Butler. Kamar Baldwin, in the midst of an 11-0 Creighton run, walks slowly toward the Butler bench.
Thinking of the look at it, Baldwin battling inside.
Looked like he ran into the back of Aaron Thompson, maybe.
know if he stepped on his heel or what, but it looked like a collision with a teammate.
Certainly, that's it. It's going to that ankle. And he's had ankle issues in the past. He sprained his ankle against St. John's early in the conference
collision. But either way, Kamar Baldwin on the bench trying to work that out. Zegarowski with another three. That one is good.
Stress on the defense to the three-point line.
Zegarowski into the corner. The three for Tyshawn Adams.
What a camper to a marvelous first half for the Creighton Blue Jays. Thompson hustles up. His three won't go. And the Jays end the half on a 17-2 run with 10 three-pointers in the first half. Marcus Zegarowski hit five of them. 17 for Zegarowski and a 19-point halftime lead. Alexander, the long top of his down under great duress.
What did he get to the apex of his jump quickly?
Like you and I working in both duress and apex in that made that even more special.
Absolutely.
You can see on the baseline. Feeding it to Badley. He'll back it out now. And for Butler, six on the shot clock as they regather. Thompson finds a crease. Can't get it to go. Inzi with the offensive rebound. Stripped by Bishop. Jays on the run with numbers. Ballack leaving for Bishop.
Replay. I mean, lob upstairs. Bishop gets it. And this bounce pass from Ballack. No look. Bishop hammers it down. Look at this. Woo. Wow. Big time plays at the end of games.
Jefferson to Zegarowski. The three falls again. He's 6 for 6. Tying a career high with his sixth make.
And this is it, Kevin. When you pick up two personal fouls, sometimes you're not too eager to set your feet and take a charge, but Jones does anyways.
Zegarowski around the Jones screen.
7 for 7 from three.
Hey, this is unbelievable. Just refusing the ball screen. You start trying to creep over that ball screen, and Zegarowski makes you pay. This is unbelievable shooting performance.
Thompson can't get it from point-blank range. Jones the rebound. Where's Zegarowski? Ballack in the corner to Alexander.
He'll hit the three. He knew it was good. He started to look at the crowd before his 200th career three-pointer dropped. And the Jays with a 27-point lead and a Butler timeout.
Look at Zegarowski catching Thompson, peeking over that ball screen and drills a triple. And then Ballack with a great unselfish kick. It's all Creighton here this afternoon. This can be a struggle for them at times. And when you remove their catalyst star stud playmaker, it gets really challenging.
Oh, Zegarowski, a little hesitation, and then the blow by for two.
When a guy's made 7 threes, I suppose you got to crowd him a little bit.
Blue Jays up 27 at home. Ballack off the handoff. The lob inside to Jones with an easy two.
Every single thing Creighton does is working right now.
Yeah. Transition threes and then the...
Always appreciate the participation and the cooperation. 13 to shoot for Tyshawn Alexander and the Blue Jays. Bishop. Alexander hoists the three and hits the three.
A season high 14 made threes for the Blue Jays.
Not only Butler's, you got to keep on competing here. And this is a proud program that, you know, this hasn't happened to them very often as Alexander gets another one to go down.
But you can tell he's starting to feel it too. He's got to the country right now. It's a Creighton team to win their ninth out of 10.
And Christian Bishop providing plenty of highlights at the rim.
Up to Butler. Bulldogs down 30 on the road. This one was over early. The Jays dominating from the jump. Marcus Zagorowski, 7 of 7 from 3 with 25 points. Extra pass to Bishop, and Bishop's got a new high with 19 points. And a timeout taken by the Blue Jays. And a standing ovation from the crowd in Omaha. 75-43. Jordan Scurry. Having to scurry out of that trap as he kicks it to Windham in the corner. Windham hits the three. Everybody gets a three